Absolutely.
contribute to.
There it is. They got it. They
Got
got it.
Oh, come on, no them to sing.
This is a comedy. I know.
I'm not seeing this
Okay.
before.
Yes, I'm saying before we start,
So you could
I
play
want to
that
give a
part
lot of
in your
tribute to
theater. To
our technical host, Kirk
That's
Wilson, who will keep us going. All right. So, Buzzers.
So I'm to start right now.
Yeah, this is the program.
Okay, thank you very much, Tony. Greetings to everybody who have logged on already, and we look forward to all those who are going to be coming on. Unfortunately, I have another engagement at 6, which I'll have to leave here in another few minutes. So I will be very brief on the line with you. But I'm so sorry that I won't be able to stay the whole course. However, I'm happy that Tony had started the discussion and sort of made sure that it happened. So thank you, Tony and Lita, for all that you have done. And of course, you have given thanks to Kirk Wilson, who is hosting us and keeping us in check. All right. So I will start off, as per the program, welcoming everyone. And I think I'll have to visit the YouTube version after to make sure I keep up to date with everything. Now, it says here, welcome opening prayer. And I believe there should be a scripture to go with that. So, welcome, welcome, welcome. And before I do the opening prayer, I would like to read a portion of scripture which I believe reflects Elon's life. And that scripture, well, two scripture lessons coming together. It's Psalm 37, verses 23 to 33, and Proverbs 13, verse 22. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. I have been young, and now am old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. He is ever merciful and lendeth, and his seed is blessed. Depart from evil and do good, and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loveth judgment and forsaketh not his saints. They are preserved forever, but the seed of the wicked shall be cut off. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell therein forever. The mouth of the righteous speaketh wisdom, and his tongue talketh of judgment. The law of his God is in his heart. None of his steps shall slide. The wicked watcheth the righteous and seeketh to slay him. The Lord will not leave him in his hand, nor condemn him when he is judged. Proverbs 13, verse 22. A good man leaveth an inheritance to his children's children, and the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
I
God.
believe that this scripture, or these two portions of scripture, reflect the life of Elon, of how he lived his life, and how we have been impacted by his life, and how we have been proud of him. and the way he lived and how he has touched the lives of so many of us, and especially knowing that he valued education and the empowerment of people, and it didn't have to be family, but all persons who needed a helping hand for their tertiary in education especially, Elon was there to help. I can testify to many strangers that he has helped, both himself and Dulcie together. Let us pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, you have placed us in families, and as you have placed us in families, we are able to look back at the legacy of those gone on before and to really count our blessings and our heritage. Thank you for the goodly and godly heritage of our ancestors. Thank you, Lord God, for that goodly heritage that Elon left and how he touched life. Defended justice and righteousness. Thank you, Lord God, for Elon, whom we meet together today to celebrate his life and to really touch each other, even as we hope to maintain that connection and that legacy of righteousness, goodness, love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And amen. Amen. So, my relatives, cousins, all, it's so good to be on this platform seeing you. And I know to start off, we will have that video of my grandchildren singing uploaded at this time. And there are first three are children of my daughter and her husband, Cheyenne Curie and Mark. And those children are Mark Alexander, Mia Kalani, and Marley Jade Gale. And then our son and his wife, Jason Craig and Watson, and Alicia Watson, their two children, Eden J. Watson and Savannah L.A. Watson. They are going to sing a tribute now to their dear Uncle Elon. Are we having a problem uploading? I think I'm following the program.
Kirk?
Yes, Dr. Allen, I'm here.
Yes, you want to put on the song now?
No, I did not receive that song. I only got from Rosie. Oh, she has her.
I thought I sent it to you. Wait a minute. I thought I sent it to you this afternoon.
Okay, no. Okay, no worries. I understand. Yes, 1 minute.
Was yesterday.
Sure, but a new challenge. I text. But they just say, Alex, I drive my head around when I can. Looking to see if I can just tap the screen to see if there's anything.
You could ask Buzzwords, but I don't know if he could do
justice. No, I have a moment.
I was teasing Buzzwords. I'm just teasing Buzzworth.
I'm ready to go when you guys are, so I'm going to play.
Okay,
right
go
now.
Right ahead.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the ones you were here, but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories. The memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I did not know the pain. And I believed in forever, and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December, when somebody say a name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. And everything will be alright, go raise a glass and say, hey. Cheers to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones that you made. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories. All the memories bring back memories.
Well, let's give them a hand.
It was really lovely.
All right. Now, I guess, Tony,
yes,
I don't know if you want to take over at this point.
I'll do that.
I can slip out from time. And
yes.
So I'm so sorry that I can't stay the whole time. But I'm looking forward to the YouTube version that will be produced and shared. God bless you all. Love you all. And let's keep in touch. Bye.
Thank you very much, Buzzer. And we thank the children because saying that memories bring back memories and bring back you. So the memories of Uncle Elon is what is inspiring us today. All right. Now, the Mullings family is a very big one, and we're going to have a roll call. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to ask Kirk to put up here, so you can see the family tree of the Mullings, where we all come from. So we know that Edward John Mullings, married to Catherine Jane, right? But from this couple have come all these children. I'm trying to get. All right. Now, Mary Wilhelmina, that is the mother of Uncle Elon. And she married twice, but her first marriage was to a gunning, right? Can anybody help me? I can't see very well. What's it? That's that name?
Norman?
Oh, Norman Gunning.
Norman
Rufus Gunning, right? And that, of course, is the father of, yes, of Uncle Elon, Elon's father. And then he had other relatives who are, many of them may be here today, and they will announce themselves as we come. And then there is Christian Edward. That's Dr., used to be known as Dr. Mullings. And his last person that he was married to was...
Evelyn.
Yes, Whittle, right?
And oh, then,
and then there's Arthur Mullings. And I hope his son is here today, right? And the and we will see. And then there's William. And what we used to call Uncle Tin. Yes. And Beresford. That is Jean Marshall's father. Yes. Uncle Beres. And Nettie, yes, lively, short Aunt Nettie Weeks, and she commanded a great following in Harlem of all sorts of great and small people who flocked to her cooking and other things. Can we move a little more to this side? I can't see who is after Nettie. Kirk? Yes. All right. And this is Diane. Can anybody tell me? She might have died early. Diane, anybody remembers her? Stanley? I think he was in St. Lucia, I think, as a Methodist minister, right? Georgiana, she was at Turner, and I think we may have, we'll be here. And then there is Olive, who was also at Turner. I think she may have been the second wife. Any more? Kirk? That's it? All right. So what we're going to ask... Oh.
No, there's Simon and Uncle John.
Yes. Move some more, Kirk. All right. There's Uncle Simon. And the last one that you can't see, yes, is Uncle John. That's Bosworth's father. So you see how large a family. So what we're going to do in this roll call now is we can turn this off, and we're going to ask each person who is here to introduce themselves and say one which of the clan, the Mullings clan that you belong to. And if you have a spouse and children, they can be introduced also. So let's do the introduction of each now.
Who goes first though?
Shall we start as we are? Fulton is descended from Mary, the oldest.
Yes.
All right. So,
Kirk, you can take off my picture and put up everybody else. Yes. So we'll see everybody now. And okay.
Good to see you, Angie.
So, okay, so this is, I'm speaking for Fulton. This is Fulton, who's the oldest son of Raymond, who is the oldest son of Mary and Norman. And of course, Raymond was Elon's brother. And Fulton, Raymond had three sons, Fulton, Glenn, and Trevor. Right? And two daughters by his second marriage, Sandra and Jackie. And of course, Raymond predeceased Elon. So Trevor and Glenn are the two remaining sons of Raymond. Glenn in Montreal is married to Pam, and they have daughters, Roxanne and,
Claudine
and Roxanne. Fulton has two sons by his first marriage, and one of them is here, Gary. And Richard and Farah sent me a note this morning to say they'd be unable to attend. They're in Portugal. And Fulton's second marriage to me, Leanna. And we have Leon and Andrew, who live in the UK. Trevor is deceased. His wife is Hope, and they have 1, 2, 3, 4. Russell is here. One of Trevor's sons is here. He can introduce himself, and he can introduce the rest of Trevor's children. So I think that's all of our little bit.
All right. Let's keep moving then. And we'll just speak mainly for those who are here. But let's continue.
Do you want me to pick
yes.
up?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so my name is Russell Gunning. I am the youngest son from Trevor Gunning. He is, I believe, also the youngest brother of Uncle Fulton and Uncle Glenn. And he has 5 kids. The first one is Tracy. I have sister. His first son was Jason Gunning, his daughter, Shari Gunning, who lives in Miami right now. He has 2 boys, twins, Brandon Gunning, Russell Gunning, one of the twins. And he also have a niece and a nephew by Shari in Miami. The eldest, Madison, who is turned 10 this year, and her little brother Bryce, who's 4.
Okay. Any more Gunnings?
All right. Yep. So I guess I was introduced earlier, but I'm Gary Gunning. On my extreme right here, that's my mom, my Fulton's first wife, Althea, or Pauline, as everybody who knows her by that name. This is my better half, Jillian Bent. Her last name is Bent. She's a Bent from St. Elizabeth, a good St. Elizabeth girl like my mom. And I have, and then of course, you know, my brother Richard, he's away in Portugal. There's Anne Gunning as well, another sister. And then there is Leon and Andrew, who are in the UK. Of all of us, there's only one son, Matthew. He promised me I was going to pop on and say hi, but I haven't seen him, but he's the only Gunning grandchild. We carry the Gunning name because Shari has 2 others.
All right. Any other Gunnings? Well, I guess I have to declare myself because my mother was a Gunning, and of course she is the was the sister, one of the sisters of Uncle Elon. I think she was the eldest sister. And well, I am her only child, so I don't have too many to speak about except for my wife, Lita. And you can see her there. She's the one who's keeping me going. And we thank her for all her help with this production. And then there's my daughter, Deborah. Are you here, Deborah? Okay, she's not here. All right. Okay, so that's another side of the Gunnings. Any other Gunnings? Well, of course, indeed. Indeed, we have Uncle Elon's two sons. And could you declare yourselves, please? And we have a sister who will have to declare herself as well.
Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
This is Mark Gunning, the youngest of Dad's two kids in Sacramento, California. And I just want to say this is an awesome experience to talk with everyone live throughout the country and in the West Indies. And I'll turn it over to my brother, who's going to be speaking next.
Oh, thank you, Mark. Hello, everyone. Mark, I echo those sentiments. Michael Gunning here, the oldest. And I'm here in Laguna Niguel, California, behind the orange curtain, as we like to say, in Orange County, California, at Monica's house. I'm spending time with Mom and, of course, Dad's first wife. And Tony, she's yelling out to you hello and to everyone else here. So family hello, but we're here from Orange County. And just like Mark said, just awesome to do the family tree. And I saw Olive checked in. I just met Olive last week because she was here in Los Angeles and Frankie. So clearly one of the things that come out of this is the reunion aspect, which is the beautiful part of it. So thank you and greetings to all.
Now, of course, Janice was Uncle Elon's lady of honor and the one who kept him on the right track. So, Jean, you introduce yourself.
Okay. Yes, my name is Jean Gunning. I was married to Elon for 37 years, 37 wonderful years. And I am so happy that you're doing this tribute to him today. He so well deserved it. Thank you.
And there's Dulcie.
Dulcie Bunny is here. She is going to speak and say hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Still kicking.
Still kicking. All right. Yes. And you've been kicking for a long time.
Her birthday is next week and she will be 98. Tony.
Yes. Yes.
Josie's birthday is next week. She will be 98 years old.
Woo-hoo! 98 next year. So she's the, I think she's the matriarch, the Gunning matriarch. No.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
On
yes.
December 19th.
December 19th.
December 18th.
Yes.
18th. Sorry.
Happy birthday when it comes on, Dulcie.
Dulcie, yay.
And we'll all remember you. Yes, yes. Okay. All right, I think we have covered the Gunnings. Anybody else? Any other Gunnings that we haven't Covered.
If the husband is, you know, divorced, create another family, that's it. We don't really.
Who is that? Is that it?
You wouldn't call my name.
I'm hearing somebody talking, but I'm not getting the name. Kirk, are you seeing any other name there? Am I?
Go ahead. No, I think somebody's mic was open. You can proceed.
Okay, all right. Okay, then. So, Weeks.
Hello. My name is Shelley Amber Weeks. I'm the granddaughter of Nettie Mullings. And Martin was my father, and he was one of six. Nettie had six children from her first marriage to Mr. Sheldon. She had Robbie and Dolores. And then when she married my grandfather, Wilfred Weeks, she had, see if I can remember everybody in order. She had Muriel, and then she had Winnie, and then she had my father Martin, and then Joy. And Joy is the last remaining of my father's siblings. I have two sisters, Dawn and Nicole. My sister Dawn has a daughter, Danielle. We're also Gunnings. My mother is a Washington from Cave, and I've been told that the Washingtons and the Gunnings are related. And in fact, my sisters and I are here on this planet because Uncle Elon introduced my mother, his cousin on his father's side, on the Gunning side, to my father, who was his cousin on the Mulling side.
Well, you see the wonderful work that Uncle Elon has been doing.
Yes.
Now, I think we had two messages from your cousins, was it, Vita? We're not hearing.
My cousins, Daniela and Valentina were Winnie's daughters, and then Lisa and Kathy were Dolores's daughters, and so I don't believe that they're here, but I think they're going.
Yes, they sent a remembrance and two pictures. So maybe Kirk can put those up. The two pictures that were sent from Danielle and Frank.
Okay.
It's gonna be like a half an hour. Okay.
Yes,
so I'm gonna put some more up because.
Oh. So Kirk, can you put up the two pictures?
One moment.
Yeah, so it's from
Frank's right there. Philippe, is that you?
Hi, no, it's Pierre. I'm Pierre. Daniela's son.
Yes.
So Winnie's grandson. I was fiddling with the settings. I couldn't find how to activate my video. So
Pierre,
from Paris. Grand.
So this is Winnie's grandson.
So who is this now?
So this is Pierre, Frank.
Pierre.
This is Daniela's oldest son. And he's Winnie's grandson and Nettie's great grandson.
And Uncle Elon came to your wedding in 2020.
To my brother's wedding, actually.
Your brother's wedding. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So while Kirk is putting up the pictures, Daniela wrote, these two pictures were taken when Elon and Jeanne in 2017 traveled all the way from Los Angeles to be with us for Thomas and Chloe's wedding in Annecy, France. We all have wonderful memories of those days spent together. I can still picture him on the dance floor. He certainly knew how to dance. And that smile, it just shone with his love for people and for life. Elon was a beautiful person who knew how to be present even from afar. He will stay forever in our hearts. All our loving thoughts to Jeanne and Dulcie and to Michael and Mark, of course, and love to all, Daniela and Philippe. our three sons and their wives, and my sister Valentina and our father Piero. So remembrance from Daniela's family.
All true.
Okay. Did you have a picture for them, Kerr?
No, I did not receive.
I sent it, but anyway, that's all right.
All right.
That was sent with the email, but we sent you so many things, Kirk, so that's okay.
Was there somebody else, Lita?
There was, no, but this was Michelle. Michelle is from which? Michelle Mullings?
Yes, I do. I did receive that picture, and I do have it. I can project that with the message.
Okay, that's Michelle Mullings. Also known as Cousin Missy.
All right. Let's put her up, Kerr.
Right. Well, you see what she has written there? I met her beloved Elon at the Mullings family reunion. That's the last reunion we had in 2019 at Watercress. I traveled to the gathering thinking I would meet up with the NYC and West Coast relatives I've known over the years. What a blessing to celebrate with over 120 loved ones. Witnessing all the love and hard work Elon and family put into such a gathering endeared me to him. I thank him for introducing me to so many branches of Mullings. I have been adding to the Mullings family tree. I think we're part of the week's branch. Please let me know with whom I should share our family tree updates with. I hope we continue this Elon legacy. Bless, peace and blessings. Michelle Mullings.
All right, Shelley, can you help with the link here?
I'm still trying to figure it out. I have Gunnings I'm trying to figure out who live in Los Angeles, and I have Mullings that I'm trying to figure out, including Farah, who's with us today. I haven't been able to figure out Missy. We've been trying to figure it out. I think Farah knows what her connection is, though. I will let her speak for herself.
Okay.
Farah?
Good afternoon, everyone. I am so delighted to be here to join in the family and remembering Cousin Elon, cousin for me, because as Shelley just shared, I met Shelley at work at a work event, and she said, "I know you're a Mullings. We've got to be related." And I joined the family for the reunion in 2019, and I am still trying to make the connection. The closest that I've come is I did bring my uncle with me, who actually was able to identify that my grandmother is related to, and I think Olive June, maybe is the relation of I believe, because my aunt, my uncle's sister, said they would actually go to school together. So I know the connection is through my grandmother, Cicely Mullings. My father's Peter Mullings. I was I grew up in Saint Elizabeth, so I am still trying to make the connections with the Mullings side. I'm still meeting relatives. Every time I go to Jamaica, I'm meeting somebody new, but I'm just delighted to know how big this family is, how special it is, and the legacy that continues on through generations. And I hope that, as Michelle has expressed, that we will continue to carry on Elon and the family's legacy of bringing the family members together in through a reunion, so that we can continue to stay united, stay connected, and connect those dots. Back to you. Thank you.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you. And there are three, it is said that there were three Mullings brothers who came from Ireland. So, some people say Scotland. What have most of you heard? Scotland?
I've heard that it was Ireland, but
yes,
that
Ireland.
Their name to Mullings because Irish weren't thought very well of.
Yes.
My understanding is that they were Irish. I've done my ancestry tree, and what's interesting is it shows that a good portion of my blood is from the UK, and there's a specific portion that like specifies Irish. So
yes.
I'm saying it's Irish, and that's the understanding that I have.
I would agree, because when I was in Scotland, I couldn't find any Mullings with a G at all, you know, and it was all Mullins. All right. So, okay. So one went to Westmoreland, and, you know, that's where all the Gunning people and Arthur, et cetera, right? Wilhelmina and so on. And, well, you know, they were in St. James, actually, Arthur's family. One went to Westmoreland, which was Wilhelmina, etc. One was in St. Elizabeth. So you'll find many Mullings in all these places. I mean, you know, if you were to try to find all the Mullings in Jamaica, you would take the next year. Okay. All right.
Well, let me interject there for a sec. So my mom here, she is actually related to the Mullings in St. Louis.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah. So I think I'm a little inbred. That's probably primarily so.
Yes.
Can I ask a question with the St. Elizabeth Mullings? Is it the Mullings that are concentrated in Malvern?
Mountainside.
Okay.
But I think they're related to the ones in Malvern as well.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. All right. Anybody else? We covered everybody with the roll call. This has taken some time.
Bosworth family from Uncle John, Uncle Mullings side of family.
So from Bosworth family, here. Who is here?
Yes, Angela and Olive and
Jennifer is on as well.
Yes. So let's hear from you, please.
Uncle John's family.
Yes. Uncle John's family.
So there are six of us. Marie, I'm not sure if she's on. And then Bosworth, you saw earlier today. Jennifer, I believe she's on. Myself, I'm Angela. And then Olive and Melville. So there are six of us. And some of our children are on. I think I saw Wendy on early and Andrea, who's there as Faith. I don't know who else is on. But that's us.
Okay.
So Denise is on?
She was on. I don't know if she's still on. It looks like she is on. Denise, are you there?
Any of the other siblings are Denise?
You may have to unmute, I think.
Oh, hi, everybody. I'm Alicia Watson. I'm just the daughter-in-law of Bosworth and Denise. I'm married to Jason Craig, their son.
Okay.
So happy to be here celebrating the life of Uncle Ela.
All right.
And there's a Faith that is on. Who is Faith?
And
Cynthia?
Unmute yourself, Faith.
Faith?
Anybody who hasn't announced themselves yet?
Okay, I'm Olive, and my husband Frankie is here. I don't know. We're in the car, so it's sort of dark. I'm not sure.
Enlarge him, Kirk. Enlarge him.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, yes. So we're seeing it clearly.
Right. So I am the last daughter of John, Melville John. And we have four children. Bevan our first, Wendell the second, Amber and Malik. And we have 9 grandchildren and a great grandchild on the way.
Wow.
So that's it. And I think Wendy's on. She can introduce herself. I saw her. All right.
Come on, Wendy, and Kirk could enlarge her.
No.
Wendy?
No, I don't think I see her.
All right. Anybody else?
Yes, and Walter is here with me. I think some of you have met him.
Okay.
See him.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
Uncle Ealing was a wonderful man. I'm so proud to have met him.
Yes.
He inspired everyone, including myself.
Yes.
And he doesn't say a whole lot, but what he says means much.
Yes, yes.
And yeah, we have.
That's Angela.
Yes, and we have 4 children, but everyone is off on their own now. I believe Faith was on. She's Andrea, goes by Faith. The others are not on the on today. Yeah. And yeah. We have 4 grandchildren. They're all okay as well. And I believe Jennifer might be on with Denise.
Wonderful.
And
Jennifer
then,
and Denise. Kirk, can you enlarge him? Identify yourself, Denise.
Maybe they are away.
Oh. All right. Anybody else who we have not identified?
Angie's on.
So Angie, come on.
Yes.
So enlarge.
Hi, family.
Enlarge, Kirk.
You're hearing me? All right. Good.
There we go.
Daddy beside me, Arthur Samuel Mullins, son of Arthur Samuel Mullins Sr., that we saw on the family tree earlier. So I am his first daughter, Angela. Rosie's here with me too. Rosie, show your face. Right. And Maria and Sean are online too, and I think they'll introduce themselves. Arthur Samuel Mullins Sr. had the most kids, 12 in all. So we're a big branch. I think a few other members might be on, but I'll let Maria say hello.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so,
come on, Maria.
I'm Maria. Angela and Rosie's last sister, younger sister, and married to Sean, and we live in Barbados. We have 2 daughters. Yes.
I remember.
And Dulcie came to visit me in Barbados a few years ago, so that was quite a treat.
Yes. Yeah. All right. Any other siblings? All right. Anybody else?
All right, that looks like it.
That is it? Nobody else? All right. Oh, well. It seems to me that it's only one Mullings, one person I've heard of who has had probably less than 5 children, and that's my mother. Well, and Dulcie, of course, but I mean, you know, seems like the Mullings are used to having significant fecundity, right? But it's good to know that we have such a large family and such a fertile family, and you know, we are making a lot of difference in different ways. And we have a good godly heritage too, you know, because there are how many ministers? There is Bosworth, who is a minister. There is Uncle Eddie's son, Carlton, deceased. who was a minister. There is, help me, there is, oh, then son, that's Stephen.
Stephen.
Yes, who is a minister, right?
Stephen's father, Denham.
Denham was a minister, yes.
And so his quite, wife.
Yes, Hyacinth, yes.
A minister. Peter, Canon Peter.
Oh, yes, Canon Peter Mullings. And his father now is, oh Lord.
Arthur.
Oh yes, Arthur. Yes, Arthur Mullings. Yes, yes, yes. So quite a few. All right. So this has taken some time, but I think it's worth it, you know. And hopefully this is the last time myself at my age, you know, can't do anything like this. So hopefully others will take up, you know, because I have taken the baton from Uncle Elon to do this. But we hope that there are others. Because you all have the mailing list. Everybody should have it. So, you know, we can keep doing this. All right. Now, yeah? Was that somebody?
No.
All right. Okay, let's move on. Okay. Some, we heard a few comments, but at this time, we'll just spend a few minutes, you know, reminiscing because we, most of us didn't get to attend the funeral. But, you know, we said we'd gather as Uncle Elon's relatives and reminisce about our experience of him and just, you know, chew the fat, so to speak, and just share.
Are we still having the picture story, Tony?
Oh, Lord have mercy. Sorry, let's have Rose's picture story. That's very important.
Hello.
Yes.
Mrs. Denise has been trying to get on for the longest while. Alyssa, don't leave me yet.
Well, we'll have to catch you afterwards.
What am I saying now?
So just hold on while I look at the pictures. As Wilhelmina. Uncle Eddie. Carlton on the left. Arthur. All the weeks, berries, and there's Jean and Goody, and that's Uncle John and all his clan. And Catherine Powell. And that's my grandmother. And that's my mother on the left there. And these look like some Gunnings, members of the Gunning family. So Trevor on the right, Fulton on the left. And of course, you see the lovers. That's my mother in the middle, Dulcie on the left. And you see where they all grew up. All the Goddings grew up. And Melville lives there now. And these are, yes. And that's Carol, I think. Who is that?
That was Glover McIntyre. He passed.
Glover McIntyre.
Oh, yes. That was Dawn and her husband, Meryl's daughter. And this is Jennifer. And that is Marie, about her sister and
that was Judy Palomino, and I think this is
yes, thank you.
And then that was Farah's mother or grandma.
Yes,
that was my mom.
Okay, can we go back? You can go back to the PowerPoint. Okay,
Jason.
That was Jason and his daughter.
Uncle Elon.
Lucy, yes. In their younger days.
Jennifer.
What year was this?
That's my sisters and me. That's
2019.
Oh, I was
sorry. That's Stephen. Lita, tell me, who is this query quickly?
So this is my uncle,
Pike,
the one
McIntyre Pike. Yes.
That's Marie, who just spoke.
Marie.
This is Lisa Harvey, my first cousin, Dolores' daughter.
Yes.
And Joyce.
Who person with her is from Australia? Can anybody help me? Okay.
Gail McIntyre.
Gail Roos, yeah.
Ruth, yes. Gail Ruth, yes.
Mabel Mullins.
And that is, of course, Mabel of past memory, and Melville,
and Dawn.
Aunt Mabel again.
And Mabel, yes. And the person was... That is Peter there.
That's my father and my cousin Lisa.
Okay, wonderful. Yes. Olive.
Meryl.
That's Meryl on the left and her husband. Both of them passed. And her daughter. Yes, Goody and Jean. Beresford's son, daughter, and McIntyre Pike again. Bosworth and Denise.
That's me.
Yes, there you go.
This is Philippe. That's Pierre's father.
Okay. And that's Goody. My mother on the left, and Uncle Raymond, Melville. But you should be able to make out several people there. Is that Stephen and his wife? Jordan Rue, the last of buzzwords. The one with the beard you just saw was Carlton's son. Yes. Is that Carol there? Okay.
That's Kishian.
Keisha, Yes, yes. Who are the ones on the right and middle? Okay. All right. And then he's on the right and and Liana and Aunt Dulce. And myself and my better half. So those are some gunnings there.
Tracy and Brandon.
Okay. That's Glenn.
They're Shari. And her husband, yes. Jeffrey.
They're Shari, yes. Uh-huh. And Glenn again. And Fulton. Uh-huh. Glenn and Liana.
And who Sandra. Are, right? That's Sandra coming.
Sandra. Okay. Ah. Yeah.
Me and Brandon, at least I could say, and Uncle Fulton.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Meryl and her husband.
Debbie.
And Deborah, our daughter. There's Denise again. And the lovely couple.
This is 2017 reunion.
That's 2017.
2017 reunion.
Mm-hmm.
Right in front of your house.
Yes.
At our house, yes.
Yes, there's hope, Mom.
Okay, yes. And that, who's, okay, that's Scotty, that's Angela's husband. Looks after all of us. Oh. Oh. Yes. That's Mike and his family. Okay. Thank you very much, Rosie, for that. All right. So having gone through, we just try and wrap up now with sharing our memories.
Denise was trying to get on earlier.
Oh, yes, Denise.
Trying to get on still.
Come on now, come on. And can Kirk, you can enlarge her. Enlarge her, Kirk.
Yes, we can hear you, Denise.
Yeah, we want to see you, though.
Yeah. All right, let's try to see me. Let's try. You can see me now?
Yes, yes. Yes. Enlarge her, Kirk.
Come over so you can be seen.
Yes.
Here is Jennifer. What is happening? Why are you not seeing Jennifer?
We are seeing her.
Okay.
Just
okay.
A little bit.
No, I think the person, you have a blur, you blur black background activity.
Background, yeah, you have a background.
We can't know, yeah, can't know much about that. We see her coming through now and then.
Mm-hmm. What go do ahead, I do? Am I to do anything?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Background, you have to remove the background.
All right, Jennifer wants to say something anyway. So let her speak in the meantime. I don't know. You want to talk? Just talk. Just say what you want to say.
Hello.
It's everyone, Jen. Just say hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody. How are you doing?
How do I get started?
We're all doing good.
Yeah.
All right.
You look great, Jennifer.
Thank you.
Yes. Bless you.
Well, she's well looked after.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. All right. Yes. And of course, Denise is a person who looks after everybody.
Thank you. Thank you, my dear Tony.
All right, so let's go to our last item now, our remembrances.
Yes.
And how are you, Auntie?
We're not.
Okay.
Tony, what are you asking for?
No, our recollections are comments on having known Uncle Elon. Remembering Uncle Elon. Your last item.
Can I? Not your last item.
I wanted to speak. I'm speaking for Fulton. This is a memory from way back that Fulton has when he was living in Mandeville. Uncle Elon, this is when they were little boys, and Uncle Elon with this wonderful, tall, handsome uncle who came to visit them. So he came to visit them. They were, maybe Fulton was about 10 years old. And Uncle Elon said to him and Glenn, what did you say? When you and your brother fight, who beats? And Glenn and Fulton answered simultaneously, mother and father. Get the joke?
Yeah.
Who beats? When you two fight, who beats?
Mom or dad?
The boy said, mother and father. But I would say on behalf of Fulton and I think it came out in the photographs, the wonderful reunions, because Uncle Elon and Aunt Dulcie really were the driving force behind all of these reunions. From, I remember when we were, Fulton and I were first married, there was a reunion up at Stony Hill, and I know I had two little boys at that reunion, and I met a lot of the family then, and some I haven't even seen since, but that was my first memory of a reunion. And over the years, there have been so many reunions, and it was really Uncle Elon that pushed and got it all organized, not to mention a big part of the financing of all these great times. So he's such a family person, and this is what we've really loved about him. And of course, he was very, very generous. We had I'm not sure when it was. It might have been in the 1990s. We had a really all-day reunion, but it was mainly Gunnings. It was a very early reunion, but we met so many Gunnings, and we've been in touch with them since. There were people like, I remember Uncle Elon and Aunt Dulcie were there, and there was, what's his name? Cecile's father, Herbert? No, what's his name? He was in some of the, there were quite a few photos that I'd given Rosie from that reunion, but there was Rocky. They're sort of cousins of Elon from way back on the Gunning side. And
Lance
is Rocky's son. And Lance Fulton met him by chance in the bank. He just heard someone shout at it, Mr. Gunning. And it was Lance. And that is how we made the link with Lance. And we've remained such good friends. And he has his sons, one of his sons was at that reunion. And there was George Gunning, there was Landu Gunning, there were so many Gunnings there. And we've remained quite close to them over the years. That was really, that was fantastic. I remember Norman. There's one Norman who we're still in touch with, who comes down, I think it would have been Uncle Elon's grandfather's brothers.
Yes.
That's where we know quite a few of the Gunnings. So it's Uncle Elon's grandfather's brothers. But there was one of them, Norman, who we're still in touch with. And he was introduced as Norman Gunning. And Uncle Elon said, you're my father. And Norman is he's a youngster. He's in his 60s now, I would think, but a much younger person. So that Gunning reunion was one that really stood out. And I think our other, for Fulton and I, another outstanding memory was in 2002. Uncle Elon and Aunt Dulcie insisted that we come to California, and Fulton didn't even have a US visa at that time. And he had to go and get his visa because they sent the ticket and we had to go. And we went to Los Angeles and we had the most wonderful holiday. They treated us so well. They we had a wonderful time with them. So we remember him for the family, how he's pulled the family and kept the family together, and also his generosity over the years. And I know I'm so happy to be a part of this family because I'm a family person. Of course, I'm away from my English family, but I've felt very good and very proud to be a part of this family.
Thank you very much. And Liana has made herself integral part of our family. Anybody else? Let's move on.
This is Andrea. This is Andrea Faith. I remember I was having some issues. This was like back in 2014. And I saw Uncle Elon and Aunt Dulcie in LA. And I was having some issues with my employer. And he reminded me, he said, you know, you have to remember that you are a Mullings. And Mullings, you know, they are confident in who they are. So you have to walk into a room with confidence, and they usually supersede all challenges. So just having him speak to that confidence that I was lacking and struggling with at the time when I was having an issue with my employer at the time, that that spoke to me.
Wonderful.
Okay, I'd like to share. Good evening again. As I introduce myself, I'm Alicia Watson, daughter, one of the daughter-in-laws of Denise and Bosworth, and I'm the wife of J.C. Craig Watson, who is their son, their firstborn. She probably start my video. Yes, Uncle Elon, my fond memories of Uncle Elon and Auntie Jean and Aunt Dulcie was when J.C. Craig and I went to study at the Azusa Pacific University in California. You know, we left family here in Jamaica and went to study abroad. And we actually stayed in California for 10 years, even though we had planned to just go for 2 or 3 years study, come back. You know, life took us God had another path for us. And Auntie Jean and Uncle Elon, they were a part of the rock there for us in California, being family. And they took care of us so well. And then we actually ended up starting a family in the States. We had 2 girls, and Auntie Jean and Uncle Elon just loved on them, came to birthday parties, going out, gave them the Christmas. They were like the parents there for us, who we never, since mom and dad were still in Jamaica, they were like the parents and the grandparents to them. So Uncle Jean and Aunt Dulcie will always, and Auntie Jean, they'll always have a special place in our hearts because they really made California home away from home for us. You know, we'll go to their home, spend weekends. And let me tell you, Auntie Jean has a very comfortable bed there, you see? You don't want to leave it. Auntie Jean's bed that in the guest room, oh my gosh. We would just love staying there. And her cooking, we had, you know, it was really just that safe place for us to go to. And as I said, just home away from home, and we all needed that, especially when everybody else was in Jamaica. So we'll be forever grateful to them for really being family to us there in California and really living that out in the stress there.
Thank you very much. Anybody else? Wonderful memories.
Hi, Uncle Tony, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, this is Jason Craig. I'm actually at a tennis tournament at Ligany Club with my company sponsoring, but I just joined and I caught what Alicia was saying, and I just wanted to endorse what she was saying. Uncle Elon and Auntie John and Auntie Dulce were really family there for us, you know, away from home, and we're just so grateful for what they have done. And I mean, Uncle Elon, you could always reach out to him. You never felt as if you couldn't, you know. He would always try and go the extra mile and help us. And Auntie Jean and Auntie Dulce as well. You know, they're just one and the same, all of them. So we really just appreciate them and really just wanted to join the call quickly because, I didn't want to miss this at all. So love you, Auntie Jean. Love you, Auntie Dulce. And thank you very much for all you've done for us.
Wonderful. Much appreciated. Anybody else? Well, while others might be contemplating, I'll speak for myself. My mother, as a Mullings and a Gunning, she was the unusual one who only had one child. And my father died when I was 9. And my mother did a lot of traveling, etc. So I grew up as an only child, and what I really appreciated, and I think God was very good to me, that Uncle Elon and Aunt Dulce lived so long that for most of my years, that they were, my uncle and aunt, who were, in a sense, my closest relatives, and that they were there for most of my life. Because right now, I mean, I'm 80, but while being 80, I had an uncle, and I still have an aunt. And somebody at the funeral spoke about, he would say, buddy, And I have never spoken to Uncle Elon and not found him to be in an upbeat and cheerful mood. I mean, except for a few moments, along the path of life. But he always said that, he said, Tony, if I were to complain, I would be ungrateful. And he always was the one, he said, don't worry yourself, man. Always have a cheerful and positive attitude. Because life, there's a lot in life that, you can get if you are positive. And he really helped to keep me going, as he has helped so many other people in the family. I have known few people, and of course, the second to last time I spoke to Uncle Elon, the last time I think I spoke to him, he was at Aunt Dulce's house. And I think that might have been his birthday, I think. But it was a little get-together there. But he wasn't so coherent then. But the time before that, he made sure to say, make sure, Lita, I am telling you, and believe this little, you have been a wonderful wife to Tony, and I really have appreciated you over these years. And he was the type of person who he would make sure to say things like this. And I really appreciated, you know, his thoughtfulness and his appreciation for people generally. So I thank God for this uncle. I miss him, and I really am not used getting used to his God, you know, because he would call regularly, and we would talk and what have you, you know. It's going to take some time, but I really thank God, and I thank God for Jean. Yeah, I remember that soft bed, Lita. I remember that soft bed. And Jean, when we visited, she was an extremely relaxed person. And I remember that Lita was really allowed to, you know, go to town in the kitchen, you know. And of course, Jean's cooking was one of the best. And I told Jean that when I write my book, I would give her a special chapter. But in my memories, I have a special chapter for her. And, you know, Uncle Elon made a very good choice. So special memories. And I thank God for helping my life to be what it is because of them.
Okay. So I guess we'll have to move on now. Anybody else?
Yes, we appreciate that. Yeah. Yes. Okay. I think there were two people who sent
we messages. Read those already, Tony. We read those already.
Okay. All right.
I think Melvin and Don just came out.
Okay. Now, who is that?
Melville? No. You have to unmute Melville.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Okay, great. Good night, my family, my loving family. The dogs are making a lot of noise. Let me just move away from this. You know, Uncle Elon was just a special person, to be honest. I met him quite late. I met him, but I got to know him quite late in life. But the person I met and got to know, you know, I really regretted not knowing him a lot more when I was younger and could have benefited from his advice. He was really a man who knew the world. He made you feel so special, you know, and it's one of these individuals which will always be missed by anybody he touched. I'm just saying that, you know, for me and my family, he has touched us and he has blessed us. And we give thanks. And to the rest of the family, just be strong and remember his legacy. Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right. We have the three closest members to of the family to Uncle Elon. And we just want to ask them just to share their response to, you know, all the sentiments and all that has happened at this particular time.
I guess I'll start it off. This is Mark Getting in Sacramento. First off, I just want to say to Tony and Lita, this is a remarkable undertaking that you two have put together, expressing the joy and the remembrance of my dad. I think he would be extremely pleased at the effort and all the well-beings and sentiments that have been expressed today. Most importantly, I'd say three things that I remember most about my dad. First off, he was always present. And when I say present, meaning that he was always in the moment in regards to his kids, meaning Mike and myself, and his grandkids as far as what they're undertaking and how they're developing and how they're moving forward in their lives. Secondly, I would say it's just shown the love of Jamaica and the love of the country, the love of the people, the love of the family, and the love of the island itself. And the reason why I say that is because he would do tours just to show people the beauty of the island. And I think that is so important because it's a special place to him just because he was born there, but it means so much to him. And then lastly, I always have to say, it's the Elon Gunning sayings. And knowing my brother and I growing up, I kind of chuckle because we hear it all the time. The sayings, chicken marry heart denier, or monkey belly full, gray past skin, or as he talks about, measure twice, cut once, or teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. All these sayings that we remember when we were little kids, but has stayed with us for all these years as we grow old and we pass these on to our kids. But most importantly, I would say, you know, it's the memories and those thoughts and those sayings that will always have a dear spot in my heart for my dad. And I think that moving forward, I can't say enough, but we impart most of these. As you grow older, you seem to be repeating the sayings of a father. And I repeat those sayings to my kids as they grow older. So with that being said, thank you to everyone for all the warm regards and thoughts for my dad. And this is greatly appreciated. I know many of you weren't able to attend the memorial in LA, but we did have quite a few. And I was very, I tell you, I was shocked. The people that took red eye flights just to be there for my dad during this period of time. And that meant a lot to the family. And I'm sure if my dad was still around, he would have really appreciated the warm sentiments that were expressed at that memorial. So with my deep sentiments and thoughts, thank you, thank you, thank you. And that's it. And I'll turn it over to my brother.
You know, some of you may know in my daytime job, I'm a lobbyist. And one of the things you learn in being a lobbyist, you never talk past no or talk past the yes. And so Mark just did such a wonderful job there. that I don't have much more to add other than Dad was my secret weapon in Sacramento. My father knew five of the last speakers of our state assembly. They would ask, they said, Gunning, we don't care about you. We care about your father. Where is he? In fact, Senator Anthony Portantino from Pasadena played golf with Dad last September. And he said, Gunning, I'm only doing this because of your father, not because of you. So Mark really said most of it here. Thanks to all of you, Lita, Tony. I'm just so, growing up every year, we'd say, hey, meet your cousin. And there's another cousin. And this tops them all. I met a bunch of cousins today that I've never met before. So as you could tell, full of spirit here and happiness. And thank you, Tony. Thank you, Lita. Thank you, family. And Jean, why don't you just close it out for us?
Very chic. Yes, I am Jean, Elon's wife of 37 years, and I would like to thank everyone who participated in this wonderful afternoon. Elon would be so pleased, and all of the wonderful attributes that you have given to Elon, they're all true, I can tell you. He was so close to family. He always sought out the people in Jamaica. He never forgot where he came from. He loved Jamaica. He was in touch with his relatives, something that I have never seen before, just always. He loved all of you. He was always willing to meet more relatives. And I am sure that he is resting in peace and smiling. Thank you so much for all the wonderful tributes to this man, who was a wonderful man as a husband, as a father, and as a relative. Thank you so much. It's been a wonderful afternoon.
Thank you, Jack. And thank you, Mark and Mike. And we really appreciate that. So we have had a wonderful time of sharing, and we're going to have Shelley.
Sang so beautifully at the
funeral. She was at the funeral and sang so beautifully, and we're going to be graced again by her singing for us and for Uncle Elon. Shelley.
Mike is muted.
And you can enlarge the picture, Kirk.
I'm muted, okay.
Yes.
Are you ready?
No complaints and no regrets. I still believe in chasing dreams and placing bets. But I have learned that all you give is all you get. And so you give it all you've got. I've had my share, I drank my fill, and even though I'm satisfied, I'm hungry still to see what's down another road, beyond a hill, and do it all again. So here's to life. And every joy it brings. Here's to life. To dreamers and their dreams. Funny how the time just flies. Our love can go from warm hellos to sad goodbyes and leave you with the memories you've memorized to keep your winters warm. But there's no yes in yesterday, and who knows what tomorrow brings or takes away. As long as I'm still in the game, I want to play for laughs, for life, for love. So here's to and every joy it brings. Here's to life, the dreamers and their dreams. Storms fade away though. All that's good get better. Here's to life, here's to love, and here's to you. Thank you.
We're not hearing you, Dr. Allen. Your mic is muted.
Thank you, Shelley.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Are you hearing me now?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
yes. Yes. Here's the life. Here's to love, and here's to you. It's a wonderful tribute in song to Uncle Elon, a man who lived life.
What about this one?
As many of us have shared, he lived life well. He loved people well. And we love him well. So we thank everyone for making the effort to come here to be together as part of an unwieldy, fecund Mullings family. All descending from about over 12 different children of Edward and
Catherine.
And it was, you know, as we know, as we have heard, one of the things that Uncle Elan and Aunt Dulce and John and others have done, which is has affected all of us, is to keep this family together. Because we know the background of Jamaica. We are the people who brought our ancestors from Africa, made every effort to disrupt families, to disrupt the caring and the bonding of families. But somehow, Uncle Elan and Aunt Dulcia, John and others, and all our ancestors made every effort to keep us together as a proud Mullings, a proud, cunning family. And we're going to continue that tradition. Wherever we are, that we will continue the love of Uncle Elan, continue his life, continue his tradition. So thanks for coming. And I'm sure we all had a good time, longer than we planned for. But I want to give thanks to our technical director, to Kirk. Let us give him a hand for keeping all this going well.
Thanks, Kirk.
And also to Lita, who worked with the correspondence and all the bits and pieces to hold me together and to hold this together. And we thank Rosie for those beautiful pictures. And we thank Shelley for sharing this wonderful song. And thanks to the grandchildren of Bosworth and Denise for that wonderful song about memories of you. And all of you, there are some we might have missed out specifically, but in making this a very memorable occasion. And remember, we're depending on some of you to step forward to keep this tradition going. So bless you all and have a good rest of the week. And depending on where you are, evening or afternoon or whatever. It was good to be here. Bless you all.
Thank you. Thank you.
Happy Christmas,
Tony. Thank you, Tony. See everybody.
Thank you so much, Tony.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Thank you, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Merry Christmas.
Happy birthday, Aunt Dulce.
Yes, happy birthday. Yes,
happy birthday.
Aunt Dulce. Aunt Dulce.
We've been in touch.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Okay. Bye. Bye.